Well, we've all seen it. People hitting the appraisal jackpot on one of those antique shows with something that's been sitting in their attic for decades. Wouldn't it be nice?
Wouldn't that be nice? I'm going to go look at my attic because maybe that's a pipe dream not too far off for some people. This week, the Treasure Hunters Antique Roadshow is in town, and they're looking for your treasures. Let's check in with Pete Muntean, who's in Lancaster County, with more on this. Pete, good morning.
You know, the Treasure Hunters Antique Roadshow opens today. We're at the Wingate by Wyndham on Route 30, where you might be able to turn in something like this. This antique Ferris wheel is almost 60 years old. Now it's worth about 100 bucks. You may have shelled out only a little bit of dough when you bought that back then, but I'm here with Jake Weaver. And Jake, you're the manager of this, and tell me about how this differs from the Antiques Roadshow and pawn shops. This is totally different. You guys have a fleet of your own collectors.
Yes, we have a database of about 5,000 to 6,000 collectors. We basically look at your items. We'll tell our collectors what you have, and if it's something they're interested in, we can basically make an offer based off what they're able to do for you.
What are you guys looking for? You're looking to get people really digging into their jewelry boxes. Is one of those things, gold, silver, that kind of thing?
Yeah, gold, being $1,300 plus an ounce, basically it's a huge thing right now. Your old broken jewelry, your earrings, necklaces, maybe there's an old class ring just sitting in your drawer. People are bringing that stuff in, cashing it in, making a little extra money.
You guys are here through Saturday, but you guys are seeing a lot of this business pick up because the economy's down?
Yeah, basically a lot of people don't have jobs, things like that. They need that extra money. And gold and silver and those old coins, that's a huge way of making some extra cash.
Cool, a good way of making some extra cash. I'm hoping that I might have a little extra something in my basement or attic. What about you, Laura and Jerry?
Yeah, a couple things that I could maybe head out there and have it checked out.
If they want something from the 80s, I might be able to scratch that out.
I don't know if that's old enough.
Yeah, right. All right. Pete, thanks a lot.